Friends, hope you understand the concepts properly. Question number 8, connected with normal basic profit and loss appropriation account and partners capital account by fluctuating capital method. Question number 9, that was connected with, again profit and loss appropriation account, and that is fixed capital account method, in which we prepared two accounts of partners, one fixed capital account and another current account. These were the basics. No advanced things are there. Number of formats will remain same. Majority of the items will remain same. As I said, just the topics we are going to add in that questions. Say for example, this question, question number 10 of your exercise. Again, when we are going to solve the entire one, you feel that majority of the things will remain same. Yes, that's what I am saying. If you understand these two questions properly, and if you solve related illustrations too, in that case, now these questions, these solutions becomes very easy thing for you. It's very easy to understand also. And so, what is actually needed, you must focus on the add-on things, on the toppings. The matters which obviously are new in this question, because the remaining things will remain same. Jo baki nu badhu sarkhu hoy to e to tamne avade chhe, to tamare focus kya karvanu chhe, naturally on the new things, that how we are going to solve it. And after this we'll do some experiment, something new you'll enjoy, sure. If you want to study, you'll enjoy in that experiment. But later on. First of all, let's continue with the question. Question number 10, page number started from 32, ended on 33. So I wrote 32, 33 both. Three partners instead of two. अत्यार सुधी आपने दे पार्टनर निवार करता था. So for you people, you have to take care of drawing formats also. Okay? Format मा पन, you have to take care of space and everything. Even I also have to take care. Clear? Let's continue. First of all, as usual, you must concentrate in question itself. Question proper one show. Then and then, in majority of the case, while reading the question, you can have the tricks, you can have the clues, you can have the keys in your mind. That okay, it will be like this, this will be like this. Suppose, in this kind of questions, if you read in the question that partner's capital is rupees 72,000, 48,000, 24,000. So, on this spot, you may have a click in your mind. That capital, only one effect on the credit side. Now, while reading the question, you feel that no current account balance is given, as well as they have not mentioned it is fixed capital. So, again, a click is there. Every time, clicks must be there. And so, you very well know that what to draw, of what length, and within no time you can draw the format and start answering the question with confidence, because you know the content of the question. So that is very important to understand the question first. Clear? So let's go through the question first. You have to read along with me. So let's continue reading question properly. Then and then we can solve the entire आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, शारदा, जमुना एंड गणेश आर द पार्टनर्स ऑफ अ फर्म। ऑन 1/4/16 देयर कैपिटल वॉज 72,000, 48,000 एंड 24,000 रिस्पेक्टिवली। एज पर द पार्टनरशिप डेड, 5% पर एनम इंटरेस्ट इज पेएबल ऑन ओपनिंग कैपिटल, 5% इंटरेस्ट। 8% पर एनम इंटरेस्ट विल बी चार्ज्ड ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स। मंथली सैलरी 700 इज पेएबल टू शारदा, 700 मंथली, सो 700 इंटू 12। नाउ द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, एज आई से एड ऑन टॉपिंग्स ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन। Half profit will be distributed among the partner in equal proportion, half in equal proportion, and remaining half profit in the proportion of their opening capital. Okay? Again, half profit should be distributed in equal, that is 1:1:1, and the remaining half in opening capital ratio. What to do? I'll explain, don't worry. Just concentrate in the question first. On 31/12/16, Ganesh withdrawn 600 from the firm for his personal use. On 31/12/16, Ganesh withdrawn. Profit of the firm for the year ending 31/3/17, listen carefully, after charging interest on drawings. After charging interest on drawings, but before considered the above mentioned items, was 81,600. Now 81,600 is the profit after charging drawings. So in that profit, they already included income of interest on drawings. What to do? We are going to discuss just within a minute or two. And again they decided that from the surplus of profit, after doing all these things, from the surplus of profit, 20%, but not less than 18,000. 20%, but the minimum amount should be 18,000 to be transferred to general reserve. So two topics. Another three topics I can say. One, that is distribution of profit. Second, the topic of interest and capital and profit relation. Interest on drawing, sorry. And profit relation. And third, very, very important, that is provision for general reserve. From the above information, prepare P&L appropriation account, capital account and so on. Okay, so here three important topics. One, no need for chronological order. One, distribution of profit. We already did working out over here, so I'm going to explain it later on. Second, what I personally feel most important, because this one is tough to understand by words. Question match words are catching. Normally, if you go through, then it's tough to understand. So this is most important. And third one, a normal condition, 20% of profit should be transferred to general reserve, but the minimum amount should be 18,000. Okay, so one by one we are discussing each and everything. First of all, draw the formats properly. Yes, then in the beginning four matters. Which for? And for what I am saying? Yes. Four matters having only one impact. Capital, drawings, balance of current account and profit or loss. Here we are not preparing current account because not mentioned in the question itself. So, capital drawings and profit or loss. Here this topic is good one. So let's start. First of all, capital. Partner's capital is 72,000, 48,000 and 24,000. So let's write 1416 by balance brought forward. 72,000, 48,000, 24,000. Clear? Now, drawings, they say only Ganesh. Ganesh withdraw rupees 6,000 on 31-12-16. So two drawings, 6,000. Is that clear? Okay. 72, 48, 24. This is 6. Is that clear up to that? Good. Now, the most important topic, as I say. Here, the profit given to you is 81,600. Profit given to you is 81,600. But it includes, they say, that after interest on drawings. After interest on drawings. Well, interest on drawings is an income for the firm. What they say, this 81,600 includes interest on drawings. So let's try to understand. 81,600. It is already having interest on drawings. Now what is interest on drawings? 6,000 amount of drawings. 31, 12, 16. So what you are supposed to do? You have to consider interest for only 3 months. Take care. You may commit a mistake like that. 12, 1, 2, 3. But no. The date is 31-12. Okay. So 12th month, that is December, should not be considered while calculating interest. So 3 months. January, February and yes, March. 3 months. I already showed the calculation over here. 6,000 is the amount. 8% is the rate. 3 by 100. And 3 by 12. So the amount of interest on drawings is 120, which is already included in 81,600. So before interest on drawings, the profit is 81,480, which is already shown over here. Okay. So by P&L account profit 81,480. How it comes? 81,600 minus 120. What is this 120? It is given. How this comes again? So every needed calculation is there in the question. But that's not a solution. Okay? So no one can ask that how this comes. Already it is there. How this 120 is from here. How this comes? Naturally from this calculation. Is that okay? For you, it is not needed. Aatamara karvano, nothing. Just to make you aware that how this comes. Is it okay? So 81,480. Profit. Three items. Again. One capital. One impact on the drawings, again one effect, profit, one effect. But here we discuss how it derived. Okay, now let's continue with the remaining things. They say partnership deed said interest on capital at 5%, no time limit or nothing. So for the full year, interest on capital on 72,000. Calculator chenes are there. Do calculate. You feel, sir, orally average, okay, you can do. But you must have faith in yourself for that power of calculation. So, 70,000, interest on capital 5%, 3600. 48,000, 5%, 2400. 24,000, 5%, 1200. income for the partners on credit side, always having cross relation. So on debit side, interest on capital 3600, 2400, 1200, total comes to 7200. Okay, interest on drawings, they said 8% interest, but only Ganesh withdrawn the amount 6000, 8%, and for 3 months only because they withdrawn on 3112. So 3170 interest on drawings, expense for the partner, so on debit side, income for the firm, so on credit side. Okay, at least at present you are having enough time. You can also utter, you can also speak the same words, even you can copying it, okay, in a lighter way, just thodu majak ma, but tame pan you can copy the words in the similar way, lakhti vakte, while writing the answer, while solving the question in your classwork, you can also speak like this, you can also use these words, that interest on drawings, expense for the partner, income for the firm, because it becomes a bit easier for you, maja aavshe, at the same time, concept will be clear in your mind. 120. Then what they say, active partner, Sharda, is going to get monthly 700 rupees. So 700 rupees, 12 months. Okay? So salary, 8400. For Sharda, it's an income. For the firm, it's an expense on debit side. To salary, Sharda, 7700 into 12 comes to 8400. Is it okay? Clear? Now, two matters left. One, general reserve. Another, distribution of profit. Naturally, first we have to provide for general reserve, because then and then we can come to know what the profit is. How to decide? First of all, credit side total 81600. Why credit side total first? Can't we do debit side total first? In this question I am saying. No. Why is it so? Because general reserve is a part of profit. Yes, in 11th we discuss that. So, when they say that you are going to allocate, you are going to appropriate this particular amount for general reserve, naturally the firm must be in profit. Then and then we can put a part of that profit as reserve separately. If the firm is making loss, how is it possible to make reserves, to spread a particular amount for reserve? So there is no chance of loss in this condition. Suppose, we must be ready for every condition. You may feel, you may think that it's not compulsory. Initially they decide that if the firm is in profit, spare this amount for general reserve. But it may be possible, at the end, firm is in loss. If firm is in loss, remember carefully, if firm is in loss, you cannot spare amount for general reserve. If firm is in loss, you cannot spare amount for general reserve, though the condition is given in the question. Because in question they said, if you are in profit, if and though relation is there. If you are in profit, then you can prepare, you can spare for reserves. So in case of loss, there is no question of reserve. Got my point? Good. If you don't understand, definitely you can come to me at any time. Yes, can call me or one to one we can discuss on this point. But it's very simple. If profit is there, reserve condition will be applied. If loss is there, reserve condition will not be applied. Matter ends. Yeah, it's so simple. Let's continue with this. Here on credit side, 81,600. On debit side, here in these two digits only, please take care. 7,200 interest on capital and salary 8,400. Atyar sudhi apni paise at closed portion che. So again, let's do it in the way we were doing. For you, it is not needed. I'm just doing these things for your clarity of concept. So it is 81,600 total of credit side minus this two. This two means 8,400 plus 7,200. So that comes to 15,000 total of this two. Okay, 600. By deducting this, you will get 66,000. Any problem in mind? 81,600 minus 15,600. You will get 66,000. Okay. Now, take care. What is the condition for general reserve? Go through the question. Yeah, read it properly. What is the condition? They said 20% amount is to be spare for general reserve. 20%. 66,000, 20%. That is 13,200. 13,200 in your language, in your words. 13,200. Now the condition is 20%, but minimum 18,000 must be there. Now here we got 20% of it. So that is 13,200. Okay? What they said, minimum 18,000. So initially in this case, we can't spare 13,200. We have to allocate 18,000 because minimum that amount must be there. Got my point? Good. So general reserve 18,000. Now, again an important one. General reserve 18,000 we are doing, but mind well, it is not connected with any of the partner individually. General reserve is not connected with any of the partner individually. It is the amount of profit, it is the portion of profit firm decided to put aside for further, for future benefit. Clear? Why I am explaining this? Because in that case, like this, general reserve is not going to have second effect in capital account, because individually it is not connected with any of the partner. Okay? You may feel, sir, then what about the second effect? Second effect of general reserve should be there, rather must be there, we can use on the liability side of balance sheet. Try to remember your concept of last year. Yes? Yes. I taught you that. What is it? All reserves and provisions. All reserves and provisions. Always having credit balance. Always on the liability side. Okay? Wherever you go. In accounts, all reserves and provisions having credit balance. must be recorded on the liability side of balance sheet. Clear? So second effect of this should be on the liability side of our balance sheet in our final account. On this basis, I think tomorrow a concept clear approach. Then whatever the matters, whatever the adjustments happened between partner and firm took place, the transaction took place between partners and firm must have two impacts, one in P&L account, profit and loss appropriation account, another in capital or current account. Whatever the transactions, like interest on drawings, like interest on capital, you can check up, like salary of partner, like commission to partner, like bonus to partner, like profit and loss appropriation, that is divisible profit, like interest on current account of partner, all these matters are related with partnership firm and partners. And so, having two impacts, one in firm's account, P&L appropriation account, another in partner's account, that is capital or current account. Clear? If you rewind the lecture, even this portion also, and listen it carefully once, twice, thrice, the concept becomes very easy and very clear in your mind. So let's go further. Clear for generalism? Because it's not connected with individual partner, second effect is not there in capital or current account. Now, distribution of profit, the last topic. How to distribute profit? What they say? Again, listen carefully. 50% half profit is to be distributed equally. Half profit equally. And the remaining half is in the ratio of opening capital. If they say in the ratio of capital, then also it means opening capital. Clear? Here the capital is 72,000, 48,000, 24,000. I think you know it very well how to derive the ratio from this. It is 72 is to 48 is to 24. Okay? From this, naturally, you can derive the ratio. That is directly 3 is to 2 is to 1. If you get confused, 24 na table ma nothing else, 24 ones are, 24 twos are, 24 threes are. If you feel so, 24 no table, okay, you can divide by 2, 2, 2, 2 like that. Then 36, 24 and 12. Then 18, 12. Like this also you can do, but it takes a lot of time. So better to have calculation grip and use of normal logic, common sense. Clear? Let's continue. So, here I did that working note. First of all, how this 48,000 derived? We got 66,000. If you remember, just before a few minutes, we secured 66,000 profit. Out of it, 18,000 provided to general reserve. So 66,000 minus 18,000 comes to 48,000. See, I am giving each and every small clarification. Now, obviously, it's your duty to understand it properly. If you don't, you must write it in your notebook. Actually, these things are not needed. It's not compulsory to write, but if you don't understand the concept, then you must write this. So at least you can ask me afterwards. But for that, you must have a written clarification in your classwork. Okay? So this 48,000 we derived. 48,000, how to distribute? How this 20,000, 60,000? 12,000 tons. 48,000 distributed of distribution of profit. How it comes to? They say 50% profit, mind well, 50% profit equally. 1:1:1. And the remaining 50% is in 3:2:1. 3:2:1 like this. So first of all, 48,000, 50%, that is 24,000, half of it. 24,000 equally. So 8,000. Okay. Remaining. Naturally, remaining is 24,000. It is in the ratio of 3:2:1. So that is 12,000, 8,000 and 4,000. 3:2:1. 24,000 into 3 by 6. 24,000 into 2 by 6. 24,000 into 1 by 6. Now you get 8 plus 12 comes to 20,000 of Sharda. So this 20,000 comes like this. Jamuna 8 plus 8, 16,000. And Ganesh 8 plus 4, 12,000. Is it okay? Total 24 plus 24 comes to 48,000. Any problem? Okay. Now this 48,000, 20, 16 and 12 should be transferred over here because opposite effect. Credit side, buy PL appropriation account, 20,000, 16,000 and 12,000. Is it clear? Sure. Now, at last, this is already over, total 3 years cash. For this, now there is no need to tell you how to close. Capital account always having credit balance means credit side total must be bigger. Do one by one, Sharda amount 72,000, 2600, 8400 and 20,000. Total comes to 1,04,000. First of all, close Sharda's account only. So 1,04,000 over here. Nothing on debit side. So directly to balance carried forward 1,04,000. Second, Jamuna 48,000, 2400 and 16,000. Total 66,400. The same on debit side. Again nothing. So balance here 66,400. And Ganesh 24,000, 1,200 and 12,000 share of profit. Overall total 37,200. The same total on debit side, same line. He is having something on debit side. 6,000 as drawings and 120 as interest on drawings. So after deducting this two, you will get 31,080. In your words, 31,080. Okay. 31,080 as closing balance of Ganesh. Clear? One thing. I told you previously also that in the entire question, in advance level if you want to work, a question mark should be there to balance carried forward, because at the end of the question we find this particular amount. This question mark shows that particular thing. Clear? Sure. Do it in your password properly. But before completing this, before starting rather, clear the concept of previous question, question 89 or question 12-13. Then start the question. Try to measure the timings. Automatically you will come to know that in less time you are going to complete the entire one, because the concepts are very clear. Okay. At the end, one important thing. What is it? In every session we used to say at the end some important matter. Normally, some oversmart, yes, into inverted comma I am using this word, oversmart. Some oversmart student feel like that. But sir, when you are saying they are not going to ask long questions, why to take such tension? distribution of profit and there's interest of drawings and general reason. Why to have this conceptual clarity when they are not going to ask? But friends, do remember my words that in textbook nothing is given uselessly. So they are going to ask the similar things in next chapter, final account of partnership form. They may ask you as an adjustment, this distribution of profit. Even this kind of questions are there in your textbook also. We will solve later on. But if you don't understand the concept at present, जो अत्यारे ध्यान नहीं रखो, over confident ratio that they are not going to ask, sir भले न के, it's okay. सांभळी लेवानुं. तो later on, while final accounts, you have to suffer a lot. Okay? And in such case, obviously it is tough to achieve our targets. And to achieve which result? Desired result. Please, a word magaj ma rakhjo. Desired result. Tamare je joye che result apne levanu che. Yes. We are going to get that result. We means you and me. You and the faculty. And when you, student and faculty, join together, obviously it's a partnership business. This is not a business, but we can frame a partnership. The only condition is, we are not going to get profit in this partnership. The profit yours. But when you are going to get profit, loss is also yours. So take care. We don't want to do a loss making business. Okay. So clear the concepts very nicely, becomes very useful to you in further chapters. Is it clear? Any confusion? Doubt? Query? Questions? No. That's good. Great. Go get it. Solve the entire one in your notebook. If you have any doubt, just do a proper tick mark on it and ask the question whenever you feel proper. Okay? But draw the format properly. Do working note. Even I write working note number also over here. This is an advanced step. That we are writing working note number at every here only one working note. You may have 3-4 working notes. So at the time, suppose we do a working note of interest on capital, that is working note number 2. Then you should write over here WN working note number 2. In advanced study, you have to use this kind of pattern. So we want to try, we want to make a habit of having this kind of advancement at present only, and that's why we are always ahead than others. Okay, so just clear the concept in your own way.